Okay, we're back for part two of this trilogy of errors of me talking very fast over Dragon Age Veilguard gameplay. I didn't even know there was a V in there, as if the stupid fantasy book club was self-conscious about people not taking them seriously enough. Last we left off, we were still fighting a squid elf hybrid lady and losing because I really, really suck at Monster Hunter. Actually, I'm still confused as to why I hired this lady to help me kill dragons and she's now asking for my help to kill dragons. You can't outsource menial labor back to me. That's not how it works, you moron.
She's breathing flame!
It's a dragon. While we're headed for the very obvious flat metal boss arena, let me just take the time to say you can call this a review if you haven't bought the game yet, or a let's play if you're the kind of pampered royalty that pays people to play video games for you. I call it saving time for both of us because I'm only cutting to all the good parts, which is me talking. I'm the good part. Also, I lied, I'm actually really good at Monster Hunter. No, really, I main SNS, that's how I got rich off Capcom endorsements. I lied again, I don't actually have any endorsements. What I have is a coworker who really wants to split hairs over semantics.
Dragons wouldn't have kings, they'd have queens.
Also, despite Act 2 of this game being side quests, all the side quests, I'm actually not gonna bother with a lot of the side quests because, look, there are two kinds of side quests in Dragon Age very good. The companion quests with actual work and effort put into them, and plot and cinematics and shit, and...
We're only going for 2 days.
No honey, the man of the house is talking. Why don't you go make me a very short shortcake? And the other kind are just grinding faction points for lumbago-stricken peasants.
Lumbago!
Who can't be asked to chase the fascist wizards out of their own basements. Usually delivered through the medium of a personal bulletin boards or talking heads, and really, I'd rather just hang out with Ezio, and Ezio's invisible friend.
Freed? No! We've always been here.
Seriously, put down your phones and go have an actual conversation with people. They don't have to exist, but people. And you do get a good cardio workout because you can't fast travel to your friends, and so have to run all the way through your big house every single time. See, this is what I mean. Top-notch music, artistic direction, and effort to make the companion stuff just as big and bombastic as the main plot.
And this is all that's left!
And drama!
Base, I'll always be here.
Also, drama at home.
You try fighting a hill with a sword sometime.
How did you kill it?
I mean, don't lie, y'all aren't here for the gameplay. You're here for...
Above the door.
No, not this. I said, well, thanks for the assist, but I had my shield up and everything. And now I have a deflated counter boner thanks to you. Motherfucker.
Alright, I did it. Let's see what she has to say.
It's okay, you're safe. What happened here?
That veil jumper died making sure I was safe.
Actually, no, they just ran away. I'm sure they'll be back now that I've done all the work for them. But look, here they are. Well, that was one step further on the path to chasing down rogue elven gods, so if everybody's ready, we'll just... You needy f**ks. Armor barely makes any difference. How you look, though. BioWare doesn't make RPGs so much as they do relationship simulators for people who really want to f**k space chickens. And drizzle is an important part of that equation. This is the extent of what time I'm willing to devote to the faction grind. Off. Ezio has split personality. Tash doesn't want to do the job I hired her for. What the f*** is your personal grievance that you desperately need the help of your office manager to fix? Is it this guy? Who's he, your brother? Why, you want me to give him a job? Will you be more motivated to do your job better if I do? Here depicted by a compact but still fairly useful skill tree that exists for every party member.
And my dad can forge griffin armor.
Your dad's dead. Ezio's final personal quest is literally an Assassin's Creed mission. Look at us, we're being really sneaky. That all culminates in a, well, this seems like a waste. A whole meticulously drawn courtyard and nobody even tries to kill or f*** me in it. Culminates in an elaborate showpiece confrontation followed by an all-important decision on what happens to some of the principal participants. This is the basic template for everybody and frankly, it's the best part of this RPG. Especially when you're almost guaranteed to get a worthwhile gear upgrade at the very end. I bet Ilario stole the epic sword I was supposed to get and swapped it for that piece of crap I got instead, eh? And then everybody levels up to Super Saiyan status. Now this guy, I don't even know what the f*** he is. With peppered throughout bigger missions pertaining to the critical path.
I found you some disguises.
What the? They don't even have masks? No, seriously, can I put on a hood or something? I mean, I'm glad everybody is so focused on that one goat they don't bother to pay any attention to me stealing all their shit, but...
Out of my way!
Okay, so the lesson here is, if you're a big enough Karen, you don't need masks to infiltrate a mass gang of fanatical wizards. Nah, it's okay, I killed tons of that thing to wear as hats before.
Mine now!
She's netting bread, but the bread is invisible because it's a fantasy story.
But we have to go.
Okay, I guess we'll just leave then. Why is this not game of the year? So to recap, Act 1 of this game is getting a bunch of colorful characters together to get our asses kicked by ancient elven gods, newly released from thousands of years of imprisonment, and Act 2 is dealing with the fallout of the ass kicking to help each individual character deal with their personal shit so they don't end up dying in the finale. Yes, I played Mass Effect 2 and it was great. My expression exactly.
Who are you talking about?
I can guide you to one of my old hideouts. You can use it to make your escape.
Or, you know, give us disguises that actually cover our faces or something.
You were an irritant.
There are creams you can buy for those.
Nice speech, Rose.
Why don't you f***ing work for a living, you stunted welfare king?
She carries a gloaming lantern.
Yes, yes, Malthael, we know. This game is so cool.
Hey, what's shaping?
No one says, what's shaping anymore?
I thought it was a dwarf thing.
Yeah, if you lived in Orzammar 20 years ago.
She changed from one to two hands on her hips. Shit's about to get real. Wonderful scenery, I think I came here before in an Uncharted. Terrible platforming, why even bother when I can just play Uncharted instead?
Alright, cuts us down.
Yeah. Cutter especially. Damn, look at that dude's ass. He could have been a boxer. No, really, I'm really, really good at Monster Hunter. Oh, he was riding that?
Maybe I like that. Maybe I like...
Really?
Knowledge!
Okay, so we helped Ezio take over Venice. No, really, that happened. And got Tash's mom killed because oppression of traditional conservative values is important to personal growth. No, really, that happened. And now Prissy Doctor Strange needs help to murder his ex. No, really, this is happening now. Who says this game isn't dark enough with its writing?
Puppet?
Yeah, her. And then we stole the heart of her Megazord and helped the neighborhood watch track down some lost pets.
Come here.
I don't remember why we're here, but there's only one path forward, so... Motherfucker! Oh no, 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 no. Oh right, her brother.
How tragic.
Everybody is dead, no one has personal attachments anymore. I'm the best manager.
I thought I would have followed anywhere he asked me to.
No attachments.
The butcher.
Fresh meat.
Oh shit, he's across a small body of water. I'm so screwed.
We've made it this far. No one quits.
Because I killed everybody else, you know, so the job's the only thing you have now. No. Yeah, I'm good with this. If I didn't know them, I don't f***ing care. And no war was ever won without loss or by caring for the plight of the expendable pawns. Pause this screen and you get the cover to every fantasy novel ever written in human history.
How much time do we actually have?
It's not weeks.
What? I already signed off on the disclaimer that I don't care how many of you die so long as I get to finish this game.
What?
F*** me.
I could be kicked in the head by a horse, or eat some bad shellfish, or fall asleep in the tub and drown.
I don't know that this is helping.
Okay, so I didn't get the explicit copulation scene with my hot dwarf wife yet, so...
I hope I'm not interrupting whatever you're doing.
I know what you're doing. It's nothing. Get the f*** out of my house. The spectacular explosion in the distance means we're well and truly into the endgame now, and this is very much what I'm talking about considering you have to look high and far to find a party-based RPG. With such a budget and production values, and nerds like us will be totally missing out if we chose not to play this game because, I got the Grey Warden killed, spoilers, and he was the first to die, so if anything, I'm more worried about the look of completely and utterly accidentally making sure the black guy dies first in my story than any grievance someone might have with pronouns or whatever. Also, yes, Loki does betray us. I saw it coming because I've seen The Empire Strikes Back, but don't worry, we'll get him yet in part 3, and the riveting conclusion of this trilogy of truncated Let's Plays when I finally make good on the promise to show you the spicy Qunari on dwarf action that you're all really here for. So you like wastelands and cowboys and alternative history, eh? Well, it just so happens I also write books. Genuine novels with plot and characters, and this one is available now on Amazon about an alternate World War II Pacific theater that is like Firefly mixed with Inglourious Basterds.
Yeah, feed us into your Nazi boss.
And I also have a Patreon now where if you subscribe, you get DRM-free versions of the same books as soon as they come out. Why? Because I like money. Also because I'm posting entertainment opinions on YouTube, so frankly, I should have done this years ago because you know I'm completely without capability for shame.